Hello, Pato. Now, what on earth is that? Can any of you tell Pato what that is?
It's an egg,
Pato.
It's a big egg.
Ah, you're right. I see. It is an egg. Fascinating. Oh, hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Ball? Oh, dear, but... No, Pocoyo, you and Ellie have the wrong idea here. You see, that's not really a ball. What Pato has is an egg. And very soon, something will happen to that egg. It will hatch. Now do you see why that egg is so special to Pato? Oh dear, it's time. It's time. It's... It's a spider! I suppose ducklings aren't the only things that hatch from eggs. And some people are frightened of spiders, even baby ones. I'm afraid you've given Pato a fright, baby spider. Baby spider isn't that scary, Pato. And he seems to like you. There's Pocoyo and Ellie. Hello! Oh dear. I reckon they're still too scared to play with you as long as baby spider is around. Baby spider, Peppa Pato, has a game he wants to play. He wants you to count all the stones you can find. I suppose you can go and play with Pocoyo and Ellie now, Pato. Ah, baby spider found a stone. Peppa Pato says keep counting. Can any of you tell Pato what baby spider would like to do?
Play ball.
Play!
I think you're right. He wants to play. Hello, baby bird. Oh dear. Pato Pato says, take the pencil and go and do some colouring, baby spider. What's this? Can any of you tell Ellie and Pocoyo who did that nice drawing of them?
The spider!
Baby spider!
You're right. Aw, that's so sweet! See? I knew once you got to know each other, you'd all be the best of friends. Hooray for Pato! Hooray for new friends! Bye-bye! See you soon! Hello, sleepy bird. Oh, sorry. You go back to sleep, sleepy bird. Ah, hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Ah, come to see your old friend, sleepy bird, have you? I'm afraid she's asleep as usual. Oh, wait a minute. Is she waking up? Oh, no. I think it's something else. Oh, my word. Oh, that was so close. Pocoyo? It's not actually a... Thank you, Pato. Yes, I suppose it does look like a ball, but it's shaped a little differently. Oh, I know. Can you help Pocoyo? Can any of you tell him what that is?
Egg!
It's an egg, Pocoyo!
Egg!
Egg!
An egg!
Phew, that's better. Eggs can break, I'm afraid, Pocoyo, if you're not careful. And do you know what's inside that egg, waiting to come out? Ah, Pato knows. There's a baby bird inside that egg, Pocoyo.
Baby?
That's right. I had no idea Sleepy Bird was sitting on an egg. That egg belongs up there in Sleepy Bird's nest with its mother. Oh dear, you'd best catch it, Pocoyo. Sleepy Bird will be very worried if she wakes up. Oh, there it goes! Catch it, Pocoyo! Pato, you catch it now! No, it's coming the other way! Quickly, quickly! Pato, it's behind you! Oh, my word! Oh, well done! Now, if we could just get Sleepy Bird's attention. Sleepy Bird! Sleepy Bird! Sleepy Bird! She certainly is a sound sleeper, isn't she? Nothing wakes that bird up. I suppose we'll have to find a way to get it up there ourselves, then. Yes, I'm afraid it is quite high up, Pocoyo. Perhaps we need someone taller to help us. But who? Can any of you tell Pocoyo someone who is tall enough to help us?
Ellie!
That's right! Well done. That's where an egg belongs, snug in its nest. Hooray for Pocoyo! Something's happening to the egg.
Egg. Egg.
Oh, don't worry, Pocoyo. Come closer now. You won't want to miss this. Yes. It's a little sleepy bird. Or a little not-so-sleepy bird. Well, in any case, it looks like we all have a new friend who we'll be seeing more of. If we can catch him, that is. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Five little aliens jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more aliens jumping on the bed.
Four little aliens jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more aliens jumping on the bed.
Three little aliens jumping on the bed.
One
little alien jumping on the bed. He fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more aliens jumping on the bed.
No little aliens jumping on the bed. None fell off and bumped their head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
put those
The Secret Mission. Let's go, Daddy Alien. You have a secret mission to accomplish. Come on, cheer up. Your co-workers are waiting for you.
Ho, ho, ho.
Really? This was your secret mission? To help Santa Claus? Wow! accomplished, Daddy Alien. Awesome. But what happened? The mission went perfectly. You managed to give out all the gifts in only one night.
Daddy Alien, it looks like this Christmas, Angry Alien is in great company and is having an amazing time. Merry Christmas to everyone!
Are we there yet? Hello, Ellie. Off to the beach, are you? Ah, just a quiet day by yourself. That sounds very relaxing. Why, look, there's Pato. Ellie, I think Pato wants to go with you. What's that, Pato? You wouldn't mind driving? That's very nice of you. What do you think, Ellie? Easy, Pato. Ellie was hoping for a relaxing day today. Yes, much better. More friends, Ellie. One more couldn't hurt, right, Ellie? And off we go, all together. What's the matter, Nina? Oh, of course. Pato, you'd better stop the car. You too, Pocoyo. Oh, great. Just what we needed. Which way to the beach?
Look at that. There.
Ah, very good, Ellie. Maybe he can tell us how to get there. back at the same place again. Oh, no, not again. Sun begin. Well, Ellie, there's nothing like sharing this marvelous sunset with your friends, is there? Even if it was a little hard to get to the beach. Goodbye, everyone.
Pocoyo needs some help. Pocoyo has hurt himself. Oh, there's someone who's going to make him.
Pocoyo?
Hi!
Going for a walk, I see. Chicken eggs. How curious. I wonder where their mother's gone.
What?
How wonderful! But still no mother.
Woo!
You'd better take care of these chicks until she returns. Do you think you can do it?
Yes, Pocoyo takes care.
Thank you.
You'd better follow them, Pocoyo. Maybe it's time to teach them to roost. Very good. Looks like you could use some help, Pocoyo. Maybe Pato?
No, Pato. Ellie helps Pocoyo.
Ellie? I bet she'd make a wonderful mother. Ellie, will you help Pocoyo mind these chicks? This is curious. Looks like someone's got those chicks in line. But who?
It's Pato!
What a surprise! You make a better mother hen than we thought. Amazing! You've done it! What's next, Pato? Flying! But chickens don't fly. Unbelievable! Well, you're just full of surprises, Pato. What could possibly be next? Oh no, Pato. What happened to your flock of chicks? Oh, their mothers found them at last. Well, of course, the chicks belong with their mother. Oh dear. Perhaps some rest will do you good. There we are, Pato. Get a good night's rest. Well, it looks like you've made new friends for good. Lovely. Good night, Pato. And good night to all. Sleep guard. Hi, sleepy bird. So, settling in for a nap? Thank you.
Pocoyo, you're making too much noise.
Sorry.
Pocoyo, this noise is making it hard for Sleepy Bird to take her nap.
Sorry.
Good idea. Pocoyo promises to keep everything quiet from now on. He'll be your sleep guard. What's that? It's Nina and Roberto. They're playing tag. They're so rambunctious. I suppose tag is noisy, Pocoyo. But what can they do instead that's quiet? Read a book. Much quieter. Pocoyo, it may be noisy, but Ellie must practice her tap dancing. A great idea, Pocoyo.
Shh.
Sorry. I'll whisper from now on. Hear anything, Pocoyo?
Shh.
I don't hear a thing. What now? Have found every sound there is. Let's check on Sleepy Bird. Sound asleep. Well done, Pocoyo. Pocoyo? Ah. Sweet dreams. You've earned them. Bye-bye, all. Fireman Pato. Hello, kids. I see you're ready to go for a trip on the Vamoosh.
Whoa, it's broken. I'm sorry, Ellie.
I'm afraid you'll have to postpone your trip. Kids, I think Lula is in trouble.
Lula!
Oh, it's Fireman Pato. And just in time. We'll see firsthand how a professional saves the day. What technique? What skill? This was very simple for a brave fireman like you, right, Pato? Holy cow! Amazing! Wow! This looks like another job for our hero. Oh, of course. Only a professional should attempt this mission. Oh, dear. To the rescue! Or should I say, rescue Pato? Well, at least Caterpillar is safe now. Calm down, Lula. Fred has everything under control. Forget what I said. Emergency! Luckily, we have a fireman with us. What? Okay, safety first. Keep your distance, kids. Where's the water? Come on, Pato, you've got this. Anyone can fail one, two, or even three times. It's not so bad. Pato? We have to do something, kids. Good idea. Pato can't fail this time. Oh, we need a fireman.
Help! Help!
Pato, we need you. Lula is trapped. Oh, dear. What do we do now? Vamoosh out of control. Doggy emergency. Stay calm, Lula. We'll save you.
at least you're all together. Your friends, Pato. You're the only one who can help them. You have to overcome your fears, Pato. Your friends, they need you. That's it. There goes a true hero. Technique? What skill? Hooray for Pato and hooray for this brave friendship. Goodbye, see you next time. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato. What's that, Ellie? You say it's time to tidy up? Pocoyo! Ellie says you have to help tidy up.
Sick.
Are you sick? Nurse Ellie says you have to go to bed. And you need a bandage. And you have to take medicine. Pocoyo, where are you going? Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. What's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, a dinosaur was stuck in a tree. His friend the ant came to the rescue in a fire engine. Then the ant came to the rescue in an ambulance. Then the ant came to the rescue in a police car. The dinosaur was saved. But then the ant got stuck in the tree. So the dinosaur came to the rescue in the fire engine. And the ambulance. And the police car. The ant was saved. Hooray! The end. Pocoyo, I thought you were sick. Where should Pocoyo be?
In his bed!
That's right, in his bed. Now what does Pocoyo need?
A bandage!
He needs a bandage!
Yes, he needs a bandage. And what else does he need?
He needs medicine!
That's right, when you're sick you need to take medicine. Not again.
Wheel of Colors. Welcome to the show. Today's color is black. everyone look for something black. Something black. What can you find? All right, let's see your pictures. Black sunglasses, a black phone, and a blackboard. Good! Keep searching for black things. A black hat. Perfect. A black suitcase. Excellent. And this, do you know what it is? A black ant. Very good. Hooray for black!
Where can Pocoyo be? That sounds like Pocoyo. It is Pocoyo. Ellie says you have to take your medicine, wear a bandage, and go to bed if you're sick.
Not sick.
What's that, Pocoyo? You say you're not sick anymore? Wonderful! Tidying up is much more fun than being sick.
Nurse Ellie, she will put you in bed when you're sick. Nurse Ellie will put a bandage on your head.
Medicine, bandage, bed, ambulance, fire engine, police car.
Nurse Ellie, she will give you the medicine. Nurse Ellie will take care of you. Of you.
Nurse Ellie!
Oh, sleepy bird. The phone. Sleepy bird. Perhaps if you all say, "Wake up, sleepy bird," with me, she'll awake. Ready?
Wake up, sleepy bird!
Wake up!
Wake up!
The phone! You've got to go out. I see. Well, I'm sure you can find someone to babysit baby bird. Just ask.
No, you. Pato, please. Pato,
Sleepy Bird wants to know if one of you can babysit Baby Bird for a while. No? What if the one who babysits doesn't have to tidy up? What's that, Pato? You'll babysit Baby Bird? Wonderful. So that means you'll do the tidying up, right, Pocoyo? Hello, Baby Bird. Have a nice nap. Your mother isn't here, Baby Bird. She's gone out for a little while. Now now, baby bird. Look, it's your friend Caterpillar. You'll be happy if Caterpillar can stay with you. Well, that sounds like a good idea. Oh, yeah. They're copying you, Pato. Ah, feeding time. What? That's not what your mummy feeds you. Cake? If Pato lets you have cake, will you stop crying and go straight to bed? Oh dear, Pato, it seems Caterpillar needs to use the toilet. Now! Quick, quick! Hurry, hurry! At last, time for bed. Your mother always takes you for a walk on the moon first. But you promised then you'll go straight to bed. Now to bed. Pato could really do with some help, Pocoyo. Babysitting is really hard work. I know. What if the two of you joined forces? What do you think? Should Pato and Pocoyo work together?
Yes! They should work together!
Bird wants to know what you're doing, Pocoyo.
We sleep.
Ah, Pocoyo and Pato are sleepy and want to use your beds. Okay. No, you want Pocoyo and Pato to get their own beds. Well, okay. You guys did such a super job. Sleepy Bird wants you to babysit every day. Do you think they should babysit every day?
Yes! Yes, they should do it every day.
Oh, well. Hooray for teamwork. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Ellie. Hello, Caterpillar and Baby Bird. What are those? Backpacks? I see. You're playing school. What fun. I love school. Ellie says, do you have a notebook? Notebooks. Very good. And a pencil? Yes, you have pencils. Hello, boys. Ellie says, do you want to play school?
Ball.
Oh, well.
The Martian Brothers Show.
Computer.
Suitcase. Pocoyo, Pato, are you sure you don't want to play school? What's this? A story! What fun! Shape shuffle. A circle.
Circle.
A rectangle.
Rectangle.
A triangle.
Triangle.
Circle, rectangle, triangle. What's this, Pocoyo?
Clock.
I see. You've made a clock with circles, rectangles, and triangles.
Ice cream.
An ice cream. Can you tell me the names of the shapes? What are these? And these?
Rectangles.
And these?
Triangles.
Delicious. Circle, rectangle, triangle. They've got pencils, and they're drawing. Ellie says you're not ready for school. You need some things. Can you tell me what these are?
They're backpacks.
Can you tell me what these are?
Notebooks.
And what are these?
They're pencils.
Pencils.
Now everyone can play school. What fun!
To learn to dance.
Hello, Ellie. Oh, you have a new doll. It has two arms and two legs and a head. Wonderful. Hello, boys. Will you guard Ellie's doll?
Professor Pato.
Hello, friends. Now, class, pay attention. Professor Pato says this is a hand. A hand has fingers. This is a foot. A foot has toes. Baby bird, can you tell us what that is? Can you tell Baby Bird what that is?
It's a foot!
It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
Foot!
Wonderful! Now we've all learned about fingers and toes. Thank you, Professor Pato.
Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
Oh, dear. Pato, be careful. This is not good. Oh, no. Pocoyo, Pato, don't. Pocoyo, is that a good idea? Cake. Thank you. Poor Ellie. Now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, paint. That's it. Everyone paint. Painting is fun. Fred says, take a picture. That's it. Get a camera and take a picture. Fred says, play an instrument. That's it. Playing an instrument is fun. Fred says, that's all. Do we have all the pieces? Can you tell me what that is?
It's a head!
It's a head!
And what are those?
Legs!
They're legs!
And those?
Arms!
Arms, that's right. Ah,
let's fix it.
Yay!
Let's see. Two legs and two arms and a head. Terrific! You've fixed it! Great! Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
A box. What's inside the box? Puppets.
Puppets.
Can you tell Ellie what those are?
Puppets.
The puppets.
You say we need something else? What?
Theater!
That's right, Pocoyo. It's a puppet theater. I can't wait to see this. And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. A box? A chair? Popcorn. Now, Pocoyo.
Popcorn. Bye.
Popcorn!
Well, good night. Ellie and Pocoyo are building a puppet theater.
We build!
What a beautiful puppet theater! Good work!
Curtain up!
The curtain is going up! Wow! There's just one more thing you need.
Audience!
An audience. You need someone to watch your show. Shape Shuffle. Star.
Star.
Triangle.
Triangle.
Square.
Square.
Star, triangle, square. Ooh, what's this, Pocoyo?
Christmas tree!
I see. You've made a Christmas tree with
stars, triangles, and a square. A rocket.
Rocket.
Can you tell me the names of the shapes? What are these?
Stars.
They're stars.
And these?
Triangles.
And these?
Squares. They're squares.
Star, triangle, square. Hello, Pato.
Look!
Can you tell Pato what that is?
A puppet theatre!
That's right. It's a puppet theatre. Pato, take a chair and sit down, please. The show is about to start. Can you say curtain up with me? Ready? Curtain up! Wonderful! What a show! Let's all clap! Bravo! Bravo!
Bye!
See you soon!
We hear the music, the show has begun. We see the puppets when the curtain goes up. Welcome to the theater, the nice puppet theater. Hope you really enjoy the show and clap when it's over.
Hello, everyone.
Hi.
And here comes Ellie. Hello, Ellie.
What have you got there?
Invitations?
How exciting. Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Pato what Ellie is inviting them to?
A tea party.
Yes, she's having a tea party. What's the matter? Don't you like Ellie's tea parties? What's that, Pato? You say Ellie has too many rules at her tea parties?
Bussy, 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 beats!
Too busy!
Last chance, boys. Wouldn't you like to go to Ellie's tea party? Well, at least Ellie will have one guest at her tea party. There's nothing better than a nice cup of tea. Except perhaps a tray of freshly baked biscuits. Yummy. Those biscuits do smell good, don't they, baby bird? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Pato what that delicious smell is?
Biscuits!
That's right. Heavenly. Well, of all the... That wasn't very nice. What's this? Looks like Ellie has another batch of delicious biscuits. If only you'd gone to her tea party, I'm sure you could have had some. And her doll say you have to put on a funny hat before you can have any biscuits. Ellie and her doll say you must first sing the biscuit anthem.
Ellie's biscuits are the best, are the best.
It seems you're supposed to dance while you sing the anthem.
Ellie's biscuits are the best, are the best, are the...
Oh, dear. My, she is bossy, isn't she? Perhaps you went a bit too far, Ellie. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what that crunching sound is? Pocoyo, what are you two up to?
Fire!
Oh, dear! Now then, Pocoyo, why don't you politely ask Ellie if you might have a biscuit? I'm sure she'll share.
Biscuit!
They do look sad, don't they? You say your friends are more important than the rules? Look what Ellie has brought for you! Now wait! Do you think Ellie's going to let you have the treats? Fantastic! Hooray for sharing! Hooray for tea parties! Bye-bye! See you soon! Hello, baby bird! And hello, Pocoyo!
Hi!
Wow! Look at that! Let's all clap. What's that, baby bird? You say that's the best ball bouncing you've ever seen in your whole life. Well, that's quite a compliment. You say that's the most amazing construction you've ever seen. Well, it's certainly a nice wall, but
better than the pyramids in Egypt. Well, if you say so, baby bird. What's this? Ah, baby bird obviously thinks your drawing is something special, Pocoyo. Well, yes, of course it's art. But better than the Mona Lisa? Well. What that? A red carpet? Goodness! Well, I suppose nothing less will do for Baby Bird's hero.
Yay!
Hello, Pato. Says you've played enough, Pato. It's his turn now. Hello, Ellie. Ah, now this is fun. Baby Bird says pushing Pocoyo is his job, Ellie. Pocoyo says he's tired, Baby Bird. He'll see you later. Oh, Baby Bird, hello. Bothering Pocoyo?
Baby Bird! Baby Bird!
You told Baby Bird to go away! Do you really want to see him again? You'll have to look through this telescope.
Sad.
Can any of you tell Pocoyo what he did that made Baby Bird sad?
He made
go away!
He made go away!
That's right. After all, he only wanted to be your friend, Pocoyo. There, there, Baby Bird. Pocoyo didn't mean it. He just needed to be by himself for a while. What's this? An invitation. Someone wants you to come to a party, Baby Bird. That was a nice apology, Pocoyo. What's that? You say that was the greatest apology ever? Hooray for Pocoyo and hooray for Baby Bird. Bye-bye. See you soon. Ah, off for an adventure in outer space.
Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hi.
What's that, Pato? You want to drive the vamoosh? Oh, dear. Pato? Can all of you tell Pato to be careful?
Be careful, Pato!
Maybe that piece wasn't very important. Then again... maybe it was? No! It looks as if you'll just have to find that missing piece of the vamoosh.
That way.
It looks like Pato wants to search in the other direction, Pocoyo. What was that? Pato heard a very strange sound, Pocoyo. Perhaps it was just your imagination, Pato. It wasn't your imagination at all. It's an alien. Pocoyo doesn't believe that Pato saw an alien. Let's all tell Pocoyo that we saw it too.
Yes! There really is an alien.
Pato! Pato!
You tell Pocoyo where the alien is.
Right ahead.
Why? It's the missing part of the vamoosh. That's why he was chasing you, Pato. He only wanted to give it back. Watermelon? Your favorite, Pato. It looks as if you've made a very special friend, Pato.
Yeah.
It's nearly nap time. Don't worry, Pato. You can visit your new friend another day. You only need to improve your driving skills just a tad. Hooray for Pato! Hooray for Pocoyo! And hooray for making new friends! Bye-bye! See you soon!